Hello friends, welcome to Sandeep's Biology. In previous video I talked about Kingdom Protista, and Kingdom Protista includes 5 groups, and these groups are, you can remember like this, CDESP. It means Chrysophytes, Dinoflagellates, Euglenoids, Slime Molds and Protozoans. In this video I'll be talking about 2 groups, Chrysophytes and Dinoflagellates. So let us see about chrysophytes. Chrysophytes contain diatoms and desmids. Desmids are also known as golden algae. And if we talk about habitat, then these organisms live in fresh and marine water, right? These are called planktons. So plankton means those organisms which float passively in water currents. So these organisms without using energy, right? That's why it is called passively, without using energy, float in water currents, and these are called planktons. They are photosynthetic, of course. They contain pigments, chlorophyll, and they do photosynthesis. So they are autotrophic. They show autotrophic mode of nutrition, right? And cell wall form 2 thin overlapping cells, as seen in soap box. Right, so it forms 2 thin overlapping cells. So here it is one cell and it is overlapped by another cell, as seen in soap box. And these cells are embedded with silica. So these organisms synthesize silica, and the cells are embedded with silica. When this organism die, the cell wall deposits accumulate over the billions of years, and this accumulation is called diatomaceous earth. So diatomaceous earth are the accumulation of cell wall deposit over the billions of years, right, of this organism. And diatomaceous earth is used in polishing and filtration of oils and syrups, right? And one important point is that diatoms are chief producers in ocean. So these diatoms are chief producers, as they are photosynthetic. That's why they are producers. And other organisms depend on diatoms are called consumers. So diatoms are chief producers in ocean. Let us talk about dinoflagellates. That is the second group of protista. Dinoflagellates are mostly marines. So habitat is marine. They are mostly marine. They are photosynthetic. So they show autotrophic mode of nutrition, right? Because they are doing photosynthesis. They contain pigment. Pigments are yellow, green, brown, blue or red. So depending on the pigment, they are having colorful cells, right? Their cell wall made up of thick cellulose plates. So thick cellulose plates are found outside the cell wall. And if we talk about red dinoflagellates, right? So red dinoflagellates rapidly multiply, and rapid multiplication of these organisms make sea appears red. And it is called red tides, right? So here you can see on screen, rapid multiplication of this organism make sea appears red, and it is called red tides. And of course this organism release toxins, and these toxins may kill other marine organism, right, where they are living. So they are mostly living in marine environment, and these toxins released by dinoflagellates may kill other marine organism. So this is about 2 groups, Chrysophytes and dinoflagellates. I'll be talking about next groups, right? Euglenoids, slime molds and protozoan in next video. So I hope this video is helpful. If you are watching this video till here, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to the channel, and thank you for watching.